flattening the curve could hurt coronavirus vaccine development. Since COVID-19 was first declared a pandemic, many parts of the world have gone on to announce that they have flattened the curve. While this may seem like good news, scientists developing coronavirus vaccines have expressed their worry that the participants in human trials may not be able to be exposed to the virus, hampering scientists' efforts. The curve, in this case, refers to the number of people who contract COVID-19 over a period of time. The steeper the curve, the more the virus has spread and infected, signaling the possible peak of infection in a certain area. However, steep infection curves also have a steep fall, considering that most people have already been infected with COVID-19. A flatter curve suggests that people still get infected with COVID-19, but over a longer period of time. Governments and health institutions worldwide have been advising the public to try to flatten the curve through collective action, including washing their hands, self-isolating when they suspect they're sick, and practicing social distancing. The problem is that vaccines can be studied only in areas where outbreaks are in full force. The pace of vaccine research slows when scientists are unable to prove if the vaccine they are developing truly works. Dr. Anthony Fauci, the U.S. top infectious disease doctor, estimates that a coronavirus vaccine could be made available by January 2021, but vaccine developers believe it could be delayed due to flattened curves. The vaccines will still need to undergo massive vaccination studies conducted on large groups of people. Dr. Paul Offit, a member of the U.S. FDA Vaccine Advisory Committee and a co-inventor of the rotavirus vaccine, said the development of a coronavirus vaccine would require enough people in the placebo group of a trial getting sick. The trial would also have to be conducted in a region or time when this virus is still causing disease. Dr. Arthur Kaplan, the director of the Division of Medical Ethics at the New York University Grossman School of Medicine, said vaccine developers at Oxford and Moderna are already getting nervous that the virus there is going to lower the natural infection rate, so they won't be able to interpret if the vaccine did anything or if it's safe. It's happened before. The world still has no Zika vaccine because the epidemic was brought under control, leaving studies uncompleted.